Hello everybody and welcome back for game two of the grand final here at Flaktest Gaming.
I'm Tom.
I'm Alex and we are currently in the picks and bans.
I'm interested to see the Rengar and Kha'Zix bans coming through.
Yep.
No hunt happening.
Yeah, Necrophilia, pretty known for his Rengar Kha'Zix. Played it last week.
Yesterday. MF. MF's gone already.
See the Vlad ban. Typical.
I'd say Necrophilia did pretty well at the start of the game, but yep. I don't know what's going on at the end there, just jumping on the Jarvan.
Yeah, some great play right there in the jungle. At a little bit too ambitious late game, jumping in on the tanks.
We do see the Thresh come on for Chain Warden, didn't get that last game.
Yeah, pretty well known. If you check his profile for his fresh play. We see Gnar hovered when Janna hovered here for Christchurch.
I think it's for some pretty basic bans. I don't think of... Is Aurelia a good ban right now?
I don't think so.
There you go. Aurelia is one of the strongest top laners at the moment, so good ban.
This is a Gragas ban, obviously. Rossmoyne's mid laner, pretty well known for his Gragas.
Seeing the Dali come through, getting those spears coming.
We're assuming that's on Neko, so we'll see how he goes with his Nidalee play.
Wonder if they're going to pick up that Jhin again.
Hope not.
That Jhin jungle, Jhin the classic. Had no faith in that. It's just come through.
It's all about the downtown. The shots from downtown.
Killing that Rengar. All four shots. Popping that GA.
American Sniper.
Probably going to see some more passive players. I think they're going to have a Janna. Look for that disengage.
Yeah, I wonder and see who they'll pick ADC-wise. Might see a Draven.
Wow, they're picking Jarvan into Janna. It's going to be hard for him to engage on that. So are we thinking Rossmoyne is going to win this one, or Rossmoyne?
I don't know.
Rossmoyne.
I don't know. Christchurch last game put on a pretty good show early game. Just couldn't pull it out. See if they can do it this time.
It was a lot closer than I expected it to be. To be honest,
really good.
Put up a good fight during the start of the game.
Yeah.
Kind of roll over towards the end, but.
Hit the Caitlyn pick.
Pretty scared bot lane with the Janna Caitlyn.
Yeah, it's a pretty strong poke. The shield, the plus damage.
Go off one of those super aggro Caitlyns, maybe. Lux, AD carry. Oh, Teemo?
I'd see a Teemo ADC. Just let him go. Doesn't look like Rossmoyne's going for the troll picks.
Just up the Jhin jungle with a Teemo AD carry.
The blind, man, so good. Please don't pick it. Please don't pick it.
I'm pretty keen on this Gnar. The disease hovered.
I'm not sure how Gnar really. Oh,
he's locked it in.
Not sure how Gnar fares against what I assume is Volibear top.
I think it's pretty good. I think the kiting's really good with the speed up from his W.
Yeah,
the jump's really good too.
Kog'Maw would be not as good as he once was with the old Rage Blade.
I much preferred Kog'Maw before the AD carry rework.
I definitely preferred him before that.
I wasn't a fan of just standing there and just melting enemy
pressing
teams.
Pressing W and then just
I wouldn't say it was the funnest thing I've ever done.
Preferred playing him mid AP.
Back when I was an AD carry main. Now I just don't even play that stuff.
So we see Lucian, LeBlanc picked. LeBlanc obviously forever a strong mid laner apparently.
Picking the Lulu, just so you Oh, not going for Lulu. Lulu would be pretty good, pretty tanky against Lil Blanc.
Yeah, looks I don't really think there's a lot of juke potential there. Same with Ziggs. Skillshot champions, kind of hard to pull off against a LeBlanc.
Ziggs is definitely a poor decision, I'd say. Maybe going for that Siege.
Orianna. Could be good with Gnar jumping.
Or even Nidalee if she goes a bit tankier. Going for those long-range leaps. We've got a pretty solid team coming down from... both teams right now.
Yeah, Rossmoyne looking pretty scary with LeBlanc, Lucian.
Really tanky with that Volibear.
Yeah, Jarvan.
Good bruiser with Jarvan.
Could be either Jarvan or Volibear top. Both pretty solid as we saw the Jarvan last game.
Yeah, he had I think he had like two assists or two kills off like 100% kill participation,
yeah,
so that's really good.
Pretty much just the AAQ combos we saw. Lucked up a few fights. Got a four-man knockup in one of the fights. Went to the Azir wall. We see how Ariana picked up. Last pick.
Pretty team fight oriented, I'd say.
Yep.
Nothing, no like 1-3-1 splits going on in this game, I don't think. Actually, Nuz not a bad split pusher, I wouldn't say, but I think he's more team fight oriented.
Yeah, definitely.
Actually, the thing is, they've got an Ariana on their team.
Interested to see the combos. They pulled off a pretty good combo game one yesterday with Malphite Ariana. We'll just have to see if they can pull it off this game with Gnar Ariana.
I think Malphite Ariana is a lot more reliable than Ariana, but. Pretty different picks to the last game, though.
Yeah, this is
quite a lot.
Yeah.
The only one that's come through twice now is what, the Jarvan and the Thresh?
Last game, it was super like late game oriented, the Vayne, the Misfortune.
Yeah, I think the only two picks that here that have come up twice in these past two games is the Thresh and the Jarvan.
Yeah, the Jarvan.
Everything else is just new. I'm surprised they didn't go with Alistar for more engage on the team fight.
Not very Christchurch, yeah. Jana probably, Alistar probably would have been a better pick than Jana.
It is good though, because they have a single LeBlanc, so.
Yeah, disengage. There's a lot of disengage.
Especially Jarvan, and against the Volibear. That's really good to take out a Volibear. Volibear can't just sprint in and hit Caitlyn now.
The Thunder God.
Can't say I've seen an Orianna in a very long time.
Had a pretty good Ariana play yesterday in the best of three, the semi. Showed up pretty good there.
So who do we think is winning this bot lane?
Bot,
I think
lane.
They're both pretty strong.
I'd say I think Caitlyn's probably going to win this one. The Lucian, the Q nerf, the ult nerf. The range is really lacking on the young Lucian.
Yeah, I think it's a good poke down. Caitlyn gets some good poke down. They should very definitely win, but I think Orleans go towards
the we'll have to see how Chain Warden shows up. He is pretty well now. Yeah,
he's got the
Chain Warden down. Have to see how he shows up.
Couldn't get it last game. Was on the Alistar last game. Got stolen from him. Got it first pick this game.
That's a pretty value. Not really, but a pretty value first pick.
He is the Chain Warden.
You get that first pick. You get that first pick opportunity. Picking the support.
I'm hoping to see some pretty good and Dali spears coming through.
Yeah, I mean, Neko, he's been showing up in the past couple of games. Been enjoying his play, so we'll just have to see how he goes on in the Dali.
Playing a few good spears on LeBlanc, and she's just out of commission. She can't really do much.
Yep. This LeBlanc, obviously going to be scary, because it's LeBlanc. Duh.
What summoners are going?
Crushing mid lanes.
Going heal on this Orianna.
It's pretty good against...
The barrier or exhaust have been better, maybe?
Yeah.
I guess the move speed's pretty important, and the extra heal is not too bad.
I mean, I myself never know what summoner to take against LeBlanc. It's just so much burst.
Yeah, definitely. As long as she didn't go ignite, as long as she got some sort of defensive summoner spell. Even though LeBlanc has gone ignite, it will nullify the heal if she uses it. But
yeah, it's going to be a lot of damage.
Because Barrio did get a buff recently with the reduced cooldown by like 30 seconds, I think it was, to like 180 from
210. Here we go.
So it wouldn't have been a bad pickup.
Just getting into loading screen.
I'm using the mic stand. Can't really hold that mic.
That's unfair. I have to hold my mic.
Chose the wrong seat, mate.
Rip.
But it is looking like Volibear top, definitely. Got the teleport.
The Thunder God going to be smacking up top lane. Okay.
Hell yeah, I'm using the stand.
I'm fine.
Alright, skins get wins. So who's winning this game, according to skins?
It's looking like Rossmoyne.
Got those two mastery 7 on the Dali from Necrophilia.
God damn! Got some mastery 6s there. Got Project Lucian. It's a pretty PogChamp skin.
You got that Lissandra summoner icon on that Orianna back in, like, what was that, early season 3?
Oh, God. That event was trash.
Yeah, that was pretty terrible. I chose the Lissandra one, though. I was going for the Ash one. Back before OCE server wasn't actually a thing. Playing on like 200 ping, thinking it was okay.
Oh, I can't. How do we even play on 200 ping? Oh, I hear the music. We must be in.
Keystone Mastery is looking pretty basic. Nothing too crazy. Strength of the Ages on the Dali, I think that's pretty alright. Going a bit bruisery. Thunderlords on Jarvan again. Going for that burst.
Oh god, yeah, he does have Thunderlords.
I don't know if the Strength of the Ages would have been better. Or even Grass, maybe.
It depends on what he's going to go, I guess. If you go in...
I think it's not too bad on jungler because you're not really trading against people, so you're going in for that jungle gank. Yeah. Burst going.
Yeah.
Definitely not a bad pickup.
See what happens level 1 here.
Looks like they're running bot side.
Rossmoyne looking for an invade. There's all 5 players are running bot.
On both teams.
Could be an interesting level 1. Don't really know who has the best level 1 here. Probably, I have to say...
I wonder what this Adali's got. LeBlanc's not unlocked anything yet. No one's unlocked the spell yet, apparently. Oh, yep. Fresh
Gamma Q first. Misses the hook.
30 seconds. LeBlanc's still got nothing. Popping that disrespect mask in. Both of them. Couldn't see the Lucian one. Too late for the Lucian.
Didn't get that. Demoralization.
It's always worth it to get that little bit of demoralization. Popping that keystone. Popping that mastery, sorry. Got that Captain Volley skin.
I got that skin.
I really wanted that skin. Didn't have any RP. I was too poor.
Forever poor Nathan in the back.
I call myself poor, but I just don't want to spend that much money on RP.
I had to buy a Volley Bear skin. The
I spent way too much
too
RP
ugly.
In League. Way too much
I think
RP.
I'm up to like 1.2. 1.2 grand on riot points.
Yeah, I'm pretty close to 1.2 grand. I'm sure I'm like just below a grand. Bad stuff.
So they got a red start from Jarvan. Didn't actually start at Krugs.
That's interesting. Must be going for an invade.
I want that. I like that stun on my junglers, but I guess we'll see what he does there if he goes for an invade or not. He probably will be able to get over to blue.
I think this Gnar should beat this Volley Bear just because of the poke coming through on
the
Gnar.
Yeah, he can kite him pretty well. Oh,
on shield first. Oh, amazing nice hook coming from Thresh. Chain Warden popping off.
No level 2 though.
Ooh, that Fervor of Battle, which is doing a lot of damage.
Hits the Q, nice. Oh, here comes the invade. This might be first blood.
Could be first blood right now. Necrophilia.
Yeah, he's gonna go down. Ooh, misses it. Still has flash.
Not sure what that Jarvan did there. He turned around.
Flash used.
Ooh, she's used heal. Your Q's coming up soon.
This might be Jarvan dead. Misses the Q. Exhaust used.
Let's save it now.
Should have Orianna coming up. No?
Nah, just jumping on his head. Getting that grasp the undying. Getting that health back. That was a pretty interesting gank going on there.
Weird little invade there.
The invade.
Yeah.
They did pop heal in bot lane though, so that's good for Chain Warden Pixels right now.
Yeah, that's definitely going to swing the laning phase into their favor.
If you get a hook on anyone, that's a pretty good fight that can start. Just going for the traps now though. It's going to be hard to get past that.
Jarvan missing a vital opportunity there. That should have been a first blood if he'd landed his EQ.
He did turn around a bit during that invade. He just kind of like stopped walking for a second and then EQ'd. Could have waited a bit. Could have flashed first to get the knockout.
He could have flashed after he missed the EQ. It still would have proc. Oh, this is not looking good. Flash used. Didn't really need to. Heal used and flash. Should
Orianna
be going down here.
Wasted flash as well.
Hook used bot lane. Snared on the... No heal here for the bot lane. Exhaust used.
Really?
Chain one takes the kill though. Jarvan's gonna live that. No way.
Shielding up.
Two kills picked up for Rossmoyne here.
The Dali's struggling to clear, it seems. Almost died on both buffs.
A lot of summoners used mid there from Rossmoyne. Flash used by Volley. Oh, I thought Ignite went down from LeBlanc, but apparently not.
Top lane just kind of a slap fest, as it usually
is. Yeah, tank boys.
Even though Gnar's not really a tank, Volley Bear's just too tanky.
I did see, I did notice Volleyball actually started Darn Shield, which is interesting.
Yeah, that's an interesting
I would have went for that Corrupt and Flare, even just going for Darns. I like to go Darns because you just have insane damage with the speed, attack speed buff and the W.
I'm more of a two rejuve beads.
Two rejuve beads.
Heard that's really good, Kappa. I think I've dabbled in a bit of Volibear top lane. It's pretty fun.
I like to follow Trick2G's way of life.
The bite damage is pretty insane. Don't really expect that kind of burst from a tank, but it happens.
Yeah, the bite is just insane.
Just, you don't really expect that much damage to come out of a Volibear.
Especially with his ult on too. It's just way too much damage.
It's really satisfying to see someone die to the lightning. Like when someone attacks a minion.
Yeah.
Kills them. Pretty satisfying.
That's a nice thing to watch.
A lot of people don't do it. A lot of people miss that opportunity. They don't really think about it. But pretty much going on right now after those two kills that happened.
Yeah, we see the serrated knife picked up from Lucian. That's going to be a pretty big power spike. And we have a little scrap here. Top went to Dali there. Spear hits a minion. Stun used, but Jarvan is there. Should be nothing there.
That's a lot of Q damage from that Gnar.
Yeah, that's big damage right there with the Volibear passive pop. And he's dancing on him.
BM's coming through. I wonder if they're going to fall for it.
They don't actually know Jarvan's there, so we'll have to see what happens there.
Oh, wow. A lot of damage coming down to this Lucian from stepping on that trap.
Oh, no.
Flip coming on this Sindali. She could be dead here.
They should be able to win this with the Volibear, no passive. Oh!
Oh, Gnar's just hit 6.
Undying Grasp lands and gets the kill.
Not even close to Mega Gnar, though. Level 4 versus level 6.
See what happens if Gnar can land his things. Flash used. He might go down to minions, actually.
Yeah, he's definitely dead.
Rip Gnar. Oh. Yeah, he's dead. We skipped away there, but he wasn't being killed.
That was a missed opportunity for the end for that job, and he could have just sat there dancing. Yeah.
Dropped a flag on him, swag flag.
Yeah, definitely. He's always up to his mark.
Nice hook. Walk up and play. Nice.
Chain Warden just didn't work.
Heal used. Nice heal there.
Does Caitlyn look like she's going to have to back now?
Bot lane's pretty close there.
Seems like everyone's about to get level 6.
Yeah, the 6 is hit here. He's gonna NC's going to go down.
Right there. Oh, another really good chain. No heal on this Caitlyn. She's definitely dead.
Oh my god.
Double TP.
Misses the spear again.
Big fight
ult used by Volibear. There should be Tri-Shirts going down.
A lot of damage coming down from this Volibear into this middle.
There's the lightning. The Thunder God himself.
Almost
should have bite. Should have bite coming up soon.
It's a double kill there for that Volibear. Popping off. 4-1.
That's what I like to see. That's what I like to see.
Your boy Ducky.
Rossmoyne really, really running away with this one. They've just had. They've just been in the right place, the right time. Chain One's been popping off with his hook.
Definitely a better start than last game for them.
Absolutely. They seem to gain their confidence back from what was happening last game.
Just after getting that Baron and Elder Dragon, there's just no way they're going to lose that game.
No.
But a 3k gold lead coming through right now. It's in a pretty comfortable spot.
Jesus.
Volibear level 7.
Still level 5 on this, yeah. Still level 5 on this Caitlyn.
The Jhin is level 4.
Yeah, bot lane, it's not looking up for bot laner.
Thresh are both level 6, so this Caitlyn and Jhin are pretty far behind. She did just hit 5, so it's not too bad. But they're looking for some Fnatic brush going on right now.
Oh, here we go.
Didn't expect anything from that.
That should be Dumplings going down. Knockup, nice little double knockup. She still should. And Flash used. Ult used. That's going to be a lot of damage, and that's a double kill for Pixels.
Rossmoyne just popping off right now.
Only silver player on this lineup.
Is Pixels the silver player?
Yep, he's a silver one.
Ready carry, silver coming through. Ocean Drake, really good. Not as good as it used to be, but definitely better than a level 1 Cloud Drake. So pretty comfortable drag. No contest.
Yeah, there's no wards. There's nothing they can really do anyway.
Nah, I was trying to push top lane as fast as I can. You know, 10-2.
They can still definitely win this.
All this LeBlanc needs to do is just, you know, sit back, get some kills, and they should be able to maintain this lead. Volibear gets really tanky, but nice spear or a nice Orianna roll can definitely bring him back.
Look at that Q damage. Nice hook again on Chain Warden. Showing off why he is the Chain Warden indeed.
Jarvan
in the back. Double kill for Jarvan. And here's Volley Top now. Should be able to win this fight. He's got his Sunfire. Compared
really good
to Phage.
Something seems to be going on in this mid lane right now. LeBlanc's running away from Vidali and Orianna. Bot tower goes down. Bot tower goes down. First tower of the game. Go on to Rossmoyne.
A great play here.
Smacked right onto the
minion. Yeah. Great play here from Rossmoyne. Really showing why they are the dominant team.
Undefeated. Go through this whole time without losing a single game, maybe. Last game looked like they could have lost it. But it looks like they've just kind of found their stride. Don't want
another definitely.
Close to 50-minute game again. And luckily no pauses come through. So
I've seen everybody's in. That's fine, this game.
But a three-man middle. Amazing hook from Chain Warden.
This guy's crazy.
Oh, a nice good Orianna roll. No follow-up, though. Oh, Chain Warden almost dies from that.
Chain Warden almost died. The exhaust saved him there, and Flash is used from the Dali to get over there.
She will get away from this. There's no way they're actually going to do that. Unless Lucian gets, like, Flash ult and channels the whole thing on the Dali. But
they might be able to win this fight, but he's
Rolly
just
BM
dancing
through.
On it.
Stepping
move.
On that trap. Absolutely.
Oh, no. No. Heal use just about saves her, but she still goes down.
E on the Dali. Really well done.
Ult use from Volleyball. He's tanking the tower here.
He could die from this.
Ooh, the fresh land.
I don't think he would die from that. I think he's going to do from the
We're seeing just really a different side here from Rossmoyne.
It's really good rotations coming through.
Another hook.
This is MVP.
Chain Warden definitely 100% showing why he is the Chain Warden.
Kills have just been spread out across the map from the Rossmoyne team. 16 kills in 11 minutes. This is just looking like an absolute stomp right now.
Yeah, this is pretty ridiculous.
I did just say before that, you know, you can come back from this, but
Oh, that's pretty big damage. Oh, that's going to be a dead Jarvan, I'm pretty sure. He has EQ. Oh, the Q misses. He's going back in. Misses the EQ combo.
Oh, wow. Amazing turnaround from this Jarvan.
Still turns the fight.
Misses his Q, but still gets it done.
I actually just noticed Jarvan actually has the attack speed jungler item.
Oh,
I felt about that one.
Oh, the spear. Oh. Really good spear coming out from Neko.
I think that's one of the first he's landed this game.
Flash hook coming down. That's a dead Neko Feely right there. 6-1 volley there. Just walking around this map. Tanky as. Doing so much damage. 0-5 Caitlyn. That's just not good for her. Got a pickaxe. Brawler's glove.
Yeah, this is a rough one for Christchurch here.
Definitely not as good as last game. I think Neko Feely on the Rengar really helped him out last game.
Yeah, we haven't seen really much impact from him this game.
He is 3-4. He's got all their kills. So he's trying his hardest, but it's not good enough.
It's really not. He's missed a lot of spears, I've been saying. And another hook landed. He's going in on this. Orianna.
Four-man Orianna right there.
Doesn't matter though. They just have the damage to counter it.
Full color.
Nobody has a. Oh,
Neko Feely getting another kill though.
There he is, the boy picking up one in the back.
Oh, she ran right into the volley, by the way. Oh, exhaust comes down.
TP's coming in from Nah here, and he's on them. We can't really see it, but he's on them. Huge damage from LeBlanc. Lucian in melee form still able to compete with Gnar's damage.
Ooh, this is a dead
That's a dead volley bear, yeah.
So Neko Feely got all the kills on the team right now. LeBlanc coming in for a
nice Gnar jump. Just dodges that.
Just through the minions, no way that he's gonna land.
Nice flash, dodges the Jarvan ult. We see a Neko creeping in the background. Look for a kill here. That's gonna be a kill. Should
be
a double.
Neko Feely got 7 kills right now.
That's my boy right there.
Probably would be good if he could spread these kills around a bit.
Yep.
Like, Nidalee doesn't have very much constant damage, unless they have some sort of, like, crazy extended team fight, where she lands a spear on like, everyone, and they have a good chance of, winning the team fight. I'm not sure how real this is, but Chain Warden apparently is ranked 20 Thresh no CE. Not sure how accurate that
Booty
is.
Booty Felger, you better not be lying to us in the chat.
calling you out.
I want to see that link, son.
Can we get some research up in here?
Oh, we have a DC. Expecting the pause here. Yep. Come on, Booty. Give me that link.
How's the CS going right now? 81 to 64 on the bot lane. 56 to 70. Wow, Nas actually out CS in the Volley Bear. I guess it's because he's been roaming around the map the entire game. But the CS actually isn't too bad. I thought it'd be a lot more sided to Rossmoyne, but Ariana's keeping up with the LeBlanc, actually beating her. So
yeah,
the
CS difference isn't that crazy in this one. It's just been really...
Bot lane is stomping them, though, because the Thresh is 19 CS and that Lucian is 81.
Oh, yeah, that's true, yeah. With the...
Targons.
Yeah.
The Relic Shield, whatever you want to call it. Face of the Mountain. Name all three. A summoner has reconnected. Just getting some research going
the
down
boys
in the chat right now.
Booty, sorry about that, man. I don't know why Nightbot timed you out. It's because you're dropping links in the chat.
But Ruby Sightstone is second-ranked Aatrox in OCE.
What is
off.
This? I'll actually... while we get into the game...
Through. As we're just doing a bit of research, some of the players... I'm not sure how much of a success being ranked 2 Aatrox is. Like, who actually plays Aatrox?
That's an interesting one right there.
This Gnar landing every single Q on this Thresh. Oh, missed that one. Not enough range on it, sadly. They're going for this Cloud Drake. Not sure if that's worth contesting.
Yeah, Cloud Drake, not really one of the...
Maybe it was like a Fire Drake.
Not really the
Drake.
Best dragon to be getting.
But Chain Warden taking so much damage right now. Spears and the Narcus. I really want to see Ruby Sightstone pull out this Aatrox now. Shows what he's made of.
Yep.
Volley Bear in the back line right now, just sprinting at this Janna.
He can just do this as well. He's so tanky and does so much damage. He's just going to destroy. Nice Janna roll, but she got stunned up there.
A few summoner smells blown. Got a secure to kill though. Thresh is just all the way at the front right now. Doesn't give a care about their damage. These Caitlyn traps are really just going to extend this game out.
Pretty much. Just set up a wall right in front of your tower.
Not that she's doing that much damage.
Storm out for a
she's
little bit.
She's 0-6, so... Can't say it's doing too much damage when they step on the trap, but... It's better than nothing. Better than nothing. I care, just... Probably gonna die here, actually. Ooh, pop splash. This could be a good fight for... Christchurch.
Yeah, they're really
Gnar
separated.
Doing a lot of damage. He's going to be able to follow this up somehow. Lucian's coming in from the side, doing a lot of damage with the Cull.
But
not on the right
Flash
target.
Used on the Janna here. Nice,
ooh, really
Ariana. Nobody there to follow up, though.
Necrophilia landing a lot of damage with these spears. LeBlanc's not being able to do much this entire fight. It's basically just been this Lucian just popping off. Bit of Volley Bear, tanking stuff. Flipping wards. It could have been a really good fight for Christchurch right there. Just really hard to follow up against.
Yeah, they were pretty... Rossmoyne
were
pretty split up right there.
Just trying to run through a Thresh box. It's just pretty hard to do.
It's happened a couple times now where Ariana's ulted and there's just been no follow-up. She's had a solid ult, 3-4 people, and nobody's been there to follow it up.
Interesting enough. No one's got any sort of different trinkets on
The Christchurch side.
Other than the Janna, I think.
Yeah.
She's
got a red trinket.
I expected a blue trinket to come out from this Kayla and just get some like out of vision, see what they're doing.
Yeah, coming up now, they're going to be really pushed into their base, so.
Trying to get some... Rossmoyne just to get some deep wards gone through. Pick off some people. This could be a pretty easy game.
Nice.
This looks like a dead Volley Bear. He could actually...
Not sure what... She really just wants to get on this. Just do the down, Kill finally onto the disease.
I wasn't sure if he had passive.
Yeah, that's the first kill going onto a different member of the Christchurch team.
It's a pretty bad score on Caitlyn and Janna right now. They've just been absolutely stomped this entire game.
Yeah, they've had a lot of pressure down there in the bot lane. They've had Jarvan coming in.
This Janna is just way too squishy.
I still think Alistar is probably a better pick than the Janna here. This game should be a dead Gnar here that we're seeing on top. Ooh!
Chain Warden missing that hook.
Looks like Jarvan's going to go down in mid.
Oh. BM coming through.
Got one lead. Get the kill.
Ooh,
the ignite.
I'm not sure why. Yeah, I don't even like him.
Yeah, delete that. Delete that. When we edit it, delete that. Delete that.
I'm not sure why I quoted that.
Edit that out. Edit that out.
But 24-8, a massive gold lead. 8k gold lead. Not as much as I expected.
They should be looking to close this one out here. They're starting to get some pretty big items on.
All they need to do is group up.
Nice. Goes for a little flash play there, Chain Warden.
Good attempt. They're allowed to do that. They're that far ahead. Why not?
Here we go. Here's the trap wall.
Zero damage.
Absolutely not going to care about it.
Just tickling him up a bit. Oh, the Nidalee's flipping.
They should not engage on this.
Jumping in.
Lucian is right there. Hook is missed, though.
Chain Warden missing a point blank hook. Pretty disappointed in that.
LeBlanc's creeping in the back line. You see they're over on blue side.
Just looking for a slow push up through the middle right now. Showing off that Master 7. Why not? So far it is looking like it's going to be a 2-0 for Rossmoyne.
Oh yeah, unless something crazy happens here. Baron
are doing a lot of damage, saying that she is 7-4.
Yeah. She has gone Runic Echo, as long as you're checking. She's quite tanky with the, won't go in there, hopefully, yet.
Volley Bear is top, and Lucian just back. There's no way we're going to go fire here.
Actually,
being a bit.
I was about to say, I thought they were looking for a little bait there, but. Oh,
Jarvan doing so much
huge damage. Flashes out from Caitlyn.
This Caitlyn needs to farm up for sure. She's
this,
just.
Yeah, this Caitlyn. Very, very. Flash. Really good on the Jarvan, though. The snipe from Caitlyn just gets hit by blocked by Chain Warden there.
Could be a dead thresh. Oh, really good Q landing. That's definitely dead.
Jarvan goes down, and Janna really far forward there. Not really sure why she was there, but she goes down regardless.
She's way too squishy to be that far forward. She should be following her team around.
Chain Warden chasing him because he knows Volley Bear's there. Caitlyn might go down
there.
Definitely
a dead necrophilia. Ooh, really
there's
good.
Another Ariana good Ariana ult comes out, and nobody's there to follow it up. Damage is going out into the Volley Bear. Caitlyn really focusing the Volley Bear for some reason. Ooh, hook
really
lands from Ariana. Heal used.
There's a double kill for the Lucian. Yeah. 11-1 Lucian right now. Going for that Korean build.
Korean build, insanely strong. Probably looking for a Phantom Dancer next. Some form of attack speed item.
But we now are at a 10k gold lead, which.
Misses a hook.
Pretty hard to come back from. I'd say it's pretty impossible at this point, especially with an Orianna that's behind.
Yeah, Caitlyn's behind. Orianna's behind. Janna.
The damage is coming from this Nidalee right now. Nah doing a bit.
Yeah,
Nah's Qs.
Yeah, Nah has picked up three kills now.
But this Caitlyn needs to farm up, get some damage somehow, get an Infinity Edge in or something. Just this Runa is doing enough.
Necrophilia going in there. Kind of dangerous, but he's under tower. He's chilling.
Necrophilia always going for the walls. He jumps.
He's a bit of a crazy one. Doesn't really seem to care about his own life.
Missed spear. There's a lot of skill shots coming through this
game. Yeah, the spears have just not been that great coming from Necrophilia this game. He's missed a fair few.
He'll just take a page from Chain Warden's book. Yeah. And those skill shots.
Ooh, almost steals the... Ariana walking into the fresh. LeBlanc misses that
chain.
A lot
of damage, though.
Dumplings picks up a kill.
Best Dummy's doing a lot of damage to this LeBlanc.
Oh, they fall for it. Oh, the flash just misses the ball.
Hits the Baron. She W'd into the Baron. That was her fault, and no one else's.
Chimp. Pure chimp.
Chimping out. If they come back from this, I'll be extremely surprised.
Yeah, it'll be impressive.
Jarvan
really caught out.
Not sure whether or not...
Caitlyn doesn't really want to go for this, though. He might just one bomber. Yep, there is that huge amount of damage. Nice little stun up.
Q, I think. Unless that was a heal that just negated that. Nope. Definitely
it might have been the Dali heal.
Regardless,
she doesn't have
healer. Jarvan did go down.
Yeah. She seems to be landing all of her spears on this Volley Bear from what I've seen.
They're all just funneling themselves into the jungle right now, dying one.
Yeah, this is a little, this is a bit of a clown fiesta coming out here. As Volley just nearly kills Necco 1v3. And Lucian now might be caught out.
They're just funneling themselves into the jungle right
now. Why
are
they?
Okay. That was an interesting turn of events.
Seems like
lost that tank.
Rossmoyne's own team questioning why. Seem to be traveling as a unit here to kill wolves.
Our audience of four is just distracting
save
us from this game.
Save
right
us
now.
From the nothing we've become.
So they've ruined their 10k gold lead.
Yeah, a little bit of a fiesta play. Goes down. And looking at Mountain Drake here, as we're only actually 20 minutes into this game, I really thought we were a lot later with the amount of kills and the amount of towers that have gone down.
Yeah, they're still at more than one kill a minute on the Rossmoyne team.
Yeah.
I'm not used to saying Rossmoyne. I was so sure it was Rossmoyne for the longest time.
It is.
Can we just say Rossmoyne, please?
Yeah, it is. Absolutely.
Can you guys just change your score name
Yeah, just change your score name for us. That'd be great. Uh-oh.
Good hook.
Okay. Yeah, he's going to go down, doing a lot of damage to Lucian in the process, but it still goes down. Nice EQ, nice ult from Gnar. But he's going to go down, and there
really
it is, again. Really, a point I want to put out there is the amount of times Orianna's ulted a 3 or 4 man, and there's just been no follow-up.
She just doesn't do enough damage right now. Team.
Everybody's just dead before there's a follow-up.
They just do no damage.
Even if Caitlyn is there or the Gnar is there, the Gnar might do a bit of damage. She's got a fair few kills.
That's a pretty interesting attempt at a combo right there on that LeBlanc. She does go down to the Janna auto attack, slowly floating in.
Janna Cloud that bops that
LeBlanc. Yeah, I'm not sure what that LeBlanc is going for. She definitely wasn't going to finish that off. She just kind of overstayed.
Here comes TP from Gnar, looking to catch this Lucian out. Probably not going to happen, though.
Yeah,
does have Ghost Blade.
Four more members around. You definitely don't want to go for that.
Looks like Lucian going to be picking up static shit next. Or rapid fire.
Yeah, rapid fire would be pretty good.
Yeah, there's the rapid fire pickup.
She's trying to get that poke back. If he gets an Infinity Edge now, there's long range crits. She's going to do so much to the Orianna and the Caitlyn.
Yeah, this Lucian's going to be slightly insane at this point.
She's got that 1-1-1-1-1 score.
Look at that.
The 5-1s.
Pretty insane score lineup from Rossmoyne. Here we go. Surely they can defend this.
Caitlyn's actually doing a decent amount of damage now. She's picked up
she's got the Infinity Edge. She's got the Ruans. Still got Cole for some reason. It's actually 4 stacks, so they might as well sell that.
This Jarvan actually is extremely squishy. I thought he was going to be tanking that. But he's gone
attack speed jungler item, but we see a fight coming in here. And Jarvan lands on a trap, but Exhaust is used.
Trying to get that cold damage going.
Pixel's not in this fight. He's going to be in there now, and he's going to pick up a kill.
Oh, a lot of damage.
Huge damage.
Right now.
Just lives
Gnar
that.
And Caitlyn almost dead, but that is a
nice little Gnar boomerang, and he goes down. Nice
that
snipe.
That is a 1-for-3 for the Christchurch team.
Nice little combo
really
there.
Well to hold onto this.
Gnar hits that boomerang, and then Caitlyn finishes it up with the ultimate. Ace in the hole, I'm pretty sure it's called.
Yeah, I believe that's what it's called.
I think you're
right in saying
that. I definitely know this game.
Played it for 6 years. I'm sure you,
yeah,
sure you
six,
know.
6 years. 6 years.
Sure
I'm pretty
sure
I know. I know some abilities.
Spells.
Summon a spell.
Yeah, that was definitely a summon a spell.
He's got it.
Spells.
Yeah,
have you seen that new game mode?
Oh, I have seen the new game mode. Huh. Oh my lord, what is going on? I saw my boy, I'm a cutie pie playing it. Not really sure what that game mode was all about. It looks a bit insane. I saw some like laser cannon.
Yep. I'm not sure what's going on.
Yeah, no idea what's happening
with
that
one. I don't want to know what's going on there.
I mean, I'm going to play it. I saw some, there's some like siege turrets and stuff that you got to kill. Misses the chain though.
Kind of reminds me of that weird Mark game mode.
Yeah, that one was weird, dude. I don't know what the hell that was.
I think I played that like once.
Was that the minion?
Really
the one where you had to like buy like extra minions and stuff?
Yeah, I think that was that. Yeah, that definitely was that one.
That
you
one.
You can like buy like clones of yourself.
I don't know what the hell that was. Yeah, you can change into your teammates and stuff.
Yeah, it's just some weird stuff.
That one was insane. So as we see the classic turtle stance coming out from
They're really good at turtle stancing with Caitlyn as well. Turtle stance Caitlyn and Orianna is really strong.
We see especially a little Baron scrap. Well. We do see Baron going down, but we can't actually.
Yeah, apparently the Gnar
the Gnar
Bolly
Bear
fight is so much more
there.
Interesting.
is
Wow.
There we go.
Really,
this is what I want to see.
Wow. Just amazing gameplay. Oh.
Wow. Get stunned in the tower. That's
Ooh,
literally going to do
so
no
much
damage.
So damage coming down. They're both...
There's a dance going on in top lane that we cannot see. There
we go.
Look at that. Wow. Just when it ends. Direct the camera.
So, Lucian and LeBlanc, looks like they're taking
a bit
of damage.
Here we go. Back to the little Baron scrap. There is wards everywhere on it.
Oh, no. Clearing that ward. I feel like they don't know it's there, actually.
Fresh does not have sweeps up. We still have apparently fixated on this.
Sadly, this Gnar has no way of stopping this Volley Bear unless he's in Mega Gnar form. So,
Trap City's going up. Flash Ooh. Hook just misses.
That would have been really good for them. That
would have been insane. Chain wanted to pull that off.
Rank 20 Thresh and OCE. Just not good enough. It's really not landing those hooks that need to be landed.
Chimping out pretty hard, though.
But it now is a 6k gold lead, so from 10k to 6k, Crusher's doing really well to stay in these games.
Yeah, as long if they try and just let this one go out, they're all going to be level 18 at some point. They're all going to have max items at some point. It's really just one mistake at that point. But right now, Rossi should be looking for picks exactly like this. Stun comes out. Oh.
Yeah, the Christchurch late game is really good with Orianna, Nidalee, Caitlyn.
Yeah, huge crits coming out there. You see the one auto attack from Caitlyn with the red buff. The nearly half health of
that
LeBlanc.
Lucian is pretty good late game. Not Caitlyn, unless those are really cold. There's a lot of damage coming out of that Janna right now.
Jarvan should be going down now. Yeah, there he goes.
Jarvan for Janna. Not sure if that's worth. But
point blank hook lands. This should be a dead Caitlyn. Flash dance still. Lands on the trap though, Lucian.
That was an interesting move by Crusher's team. Yeah. Running right up to them. Didn't have any vision other than in that bush right next to Baron. TP coming down from this volley bear. Not sure why. I guess they're going to rush this Baron now.
Yeah, with Nidalee dead.
And Janna dead.
No it should
smite.
Be a pretty free low Baron.
No smite speed in the team. So Orianna gets a good ult right now. Maybe you can just...
Yeah, if Orianna and Gnar pull off a bit of a combo here, they might be able to steal this. But Orianna's not... Yeah, then Orianna's not going to be there. That's just a free ban.
Oh,
flash flip. Doesn't work. Gets Banshee Veiled.
He did land hook.
Here we go. Caitlyn's chilling in the back line, but Lucian's just killing Orianna up top.
Ooh, it's a lot of damage from this Caitlyn right now.
She walks into melee form and just gets flipped by volley.
There's a lot of damage, though. This
Here we go.
He's almost dead.
Ult's used from Fresh.
Lives just.
Lucian actually just killed Orianna in the back line, so he's going to be there. Should be able to just pick this up.
Oh! I don't think Caitlyn realized Lucian was there. I feel like that was a miscommunication, but Neko
should be a
pickup
here from Neko. He has spawned now, but Exhaust negates all of that damage.
Really good chains.
And an ult comes down, and there goes Janna.
That's an ace right there.
This should be game. We got 13 seconds on Gnar, 10 seconds on Orianna. There should be an inhib. Should be an inhib with the Baron buff.
If they kill either one of these people, I think they can definitely get some exploits.
This is where
this comes down to Jane Ward getting a good hook right now.
Yep. This definitely could be where Volley was TP should have been used. As he just
They just
spawned.
Really wanted that Baron. I mean, they got it, so, you know.
Yeah, fair play, fair play.
I wouldn't say it's a bad play, saying as they succeeded. Because they need him, though, for the question. I guess better safe than sorry.
Ping's coming down for, I think that's an Water Drake, yep.
Yeah, it's not the Ocean Drake.
Ocean Drake.
Three dragons and a Baron, so zero dragons, zero turrets. Six turrets for Rossmoyne, zero for Christchurch.
Yeah.
It's looking pretty grim. Back to a 10k gold lead, so.
Just when Christchurch seemed to be coming back into it, something goes wrong. A Baron gets just rushed. And they just fall behind again.
Could have made that call a few times earlier, but they just can't. They just can't catch the waters.
Yeah. It's the Ocean Drake going down.
I mean, a lot of people are coming down.
I think that's the second Ocean Drake this game.
Yeah, it's second Ocean Drake. Two mountains to go. Climb the mountain.
Yeah, yeah. We see all their item passes pop.
Popping off. Is that Righteous Glory?
Yeah, Righteous Glory, Ghost Blade.
So much damage coming out of Necrophilia. Javin jumping.
There goes Javin jumping in the back line. Actually, just going to go down, though. Lucian is channeling, culling onto the Caitlyn and kills the Ferrari.
It looks like it could be game. Nah was just trying to 1v3 in that back line right there. Not sure how effective that's going to be.
Yeah, Nah just kind of baiting
this. Jay coming through right now, getting that extra move speed. And that is definitely dead.
Nice man. Chain there. It's going to go down. This should be game here. Unless they just mess it up.
41-22 with a 10.8k gold lead. If it doesn't end now, it's going to end soon.
Yeah. They really can't stall this to 18 at this point. Missed Orianna with that flash use.
Really good Orianna for the entire game, other than just then. I guess they're just trying to get pixels.
Huge
that
damage.
Is a 2-0 for Rossmoyne.
16-2 Lucian.
Huge Lucian. Amazing thresholds coming through this entire game.
Yeah, absolutely insane.
Definitely in the early game.
Yeah, chain one and really the MVP of this game. Pulled off insane hooks in the bot lane to pick up the kills for Lucian and Jarvan as we saw the roams coming down.
Necrophilia trying his hardest to keep him get back in this game. Yep. 10-10-3.
Definitely a solid player for the Christchurch team. And so that was game 2 of 5 to come. And next game, if Rossmoyne picked this up, they are going to be the grand champion. So we'll be back at you in a couple minutes with game 3 of the grand final here at Flaktest. I live my day as if it was the last. Live my day as if there was no past. Doing it all night, all summer. Doing it the way I wanna. Yeah, I'ma dance my heart out till the dawn, but I won't be done when morning comes. Doing it all night, all summer. Gonna spend it like no other. It was a rush, but I couldn't get enough. It was a rush, but I gave it up. It was a crush, now I might have wanna say too much. But that's all it was, so I gave it up. I live my day as if it was the last. Live my day as if it was the last.